handy. I work hard cause I know who I can be. One shot, ain't no room for a plan B. So I am feeling good, living better.
Before we get started.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of TSC Building the Brand, episode 2. I'm here with Charlie Staten, owner and operator.
What's up, man?
Of CJ's Ice Kream.
Love it, man. I love what you're doing, all right?
So we're here for the ride along. Hope y'all ready, because I'm ready. Let's get it.
And it's frigid in here.
Before we started recording, Charlie, we had met up with him. We had to go follow him to go to his house, correct?
Right.
And this man had said he was speeding. He was speeding in the ice cream truck. We like, bro, slow down. Like, I can't catch you. I'm a slow driver, if y'all don't know. Anyway, we like, slow down. We can't catch you. He said, man, I spent 8 hours a day going 10 miles an hour, and that was the truest statement I've heard all day. It's the funniest thing I've heard. So I understand now, because we're now going a solid 7. Yeah, a solid 8. 7 miles per hour, and now I understand his frustration. So if you see an ice cream truck and they're flying, now you know why.
They don't want it.
Now you know why, all right?
If they in the neighborhood and they flying, they don't care. They're not selling ice cream. They ain't selling
now,
ice cream.
Now, if they on the street and they flying, give them the benefit of the doubt. If they in the neighborhood and they flying, they are very inconsiderate. Don't buy ice cream from that truck, okay?
I would say the aim was not to really start it at first. I just happened to see one that got interested. And then the opportunity, you know, came out. So I ended up jumping on it. Pretty much my first vehicle was my ice cream truck. Started paying the note as if, you know, it was my car. And it just went from there, man.
Yeah. I like to count my money backwards. It's faster.
Is it working?
I always wanted to know how counting your money backwards was faster, though.
Because the BB is first. I don't know, man. It sounds good, though.
I don't think that's what he meant by backwards, though.
For real? Man, if this go pretty good, man, I've been wanting to do YouTube videos on my ice cream truck called Ice Cream Wars for the longest.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, but I was like, nah, ain't nobody gonna watch it because I do the same stuff every day.
Bro, you know,
it's just
a
different... True. I don't know. I wouldn't even watch me every day, honestly. That's the thing. If I feel like I wouldn't watch me every day, there ain't nobody gonna watch me every day.
I mean, you'll be surprised.
You will, yeah, you will be surprised.
I guess the reason behind it was because of other ice cream trucks that was like really expensive going through my neighborhood and stuff like that. They were just really expensive. I didn't even buy anything from them. Once I started doing it, I told myself I would keep my truck clean and always have like a dollar menu or something kids can always get. If they didn't have enough money, even now, if they don't have enough money, then I'll give them something for free. That's how you keep your clientele, you know, keep a base, always be in good terms with all your customers and stuff like that. So from there, it's been a good journey.
About a week after the ride that we did, I'm gonna ask you how that makes you feel in a minute, but basically breaking the news to you, one of the young men that we talked to, he gave me a call. He first commented under my picture. I forget what he said exactly. He commented on my picture, I responded. And then on my Instagram account, I have my contact information. I'm assuming that's where he got it from.
Right.
And he gives me a call, I see a mobile number, I answer it. And it sounds like a young man's voice, like a little kid's voice. And he's like, hello, is this, he was nervous. He was like, is this the shirtless chef? I was like, yes, indeed, it is. And that was flattering. I never had anybody call me like that. And it was a young man that we had talked to when we were out there throwing the football.
Yeah.
He asked, when's the next time we're coming out and making another YouTube video? So that really touched me. It's nothing that we did special with kids. It's not like we talked about anything really deep. We were just out there being with them. I know a lot of a lot of young men, even young ladies, even struggle with having that positive figure in their life.
Right.
So this ride along that we did even expanded to something bigger than what we, the core of what we do. So how did that make you feel, just being able to sow into those kids' life while you're doing the business that you're doing?
I enjoy it, and I'm sure they enjoy it. I get a great sense, you know, knowing that I do good with them. Actually, I know, like, they'll wait until they'll pass, you know, other ice cream trucks, you know, or not buy from them just to mess with CJ. Like, I'll pull up in the neighborhood, you know, like stuff like that, and like kids like looking at me, and they start doing it, you know. It's like we here with it, you know. So I've always been a positive role model, like within church or whoever I'm pretty much around. So it's always a good thing to help out, you know, younger people, or see them, or let them see you in a better light than what they probably usually see, you know what I mean? I guess that's the best I can say, you know. It's just I like being a role model.
All right, so thanks y'all for joining us with the Ride Along. Shouts out to CJ's Ice Cream, the crown jewel of frozen culinary. And remember, always, every day is a good day for ice cream. Appreciate y'all. Why you talk country?
Yeah, my one ain't got no cars on me.
Well, what would you say?
How much you got? I don't got no money.
I ain't got no cash on me.
I'm the one that gave you.
You don't want to give him cash?